Good evening, everyone. Greetings of the day. This is Komal Mathur, a legal intern at Lexis & Company and a law student at Manipal University, Jaipur. I'm glad to have this opportunity of interning with Lexis & Company, and which is why I'm presenting this video in front of you all. The purpose or topic of today's video is to discuss about the law of tort. We'll start doing it by the evolution of tort law, and then we'll read about tort law in India. Law of torts is still an unexplored charter, or at least not a thoroughly explored one, especially in countries, developing countries like India. This uncodified law is a chamber of riddles for people in growing countries like India itself. A simple illustration might make us understand this law better. 1 minute you are strolling out and about, and then on the next minute you fell down in a pit which was left open. Without having a look around, you stand up rapidly to conceal the shame you have confronted. Be that as it may, what would you be able to do? This happens often, and particularly in a nation like India. Is there any individual who can be rebuked for this? You must feel like that I have maintained mood, so I ought to be more careful from the next time, so that I do not get hurt in the next scenario. You often forget that it is municipal corporation's duty to cover that pit. They were careless in satisfying their obligation, hence they can be blamed. This is what the law of torts throws a light upon. Individual who causes such mischief shall be made liable to pay remuneration to the harmed party, which is plaintiff, which is known as damages. Keeping in mind the end goal to assert harms, there must be some break of obligation towards the offended party which brought about such damages. Regardless of whether the damage caused was not deliberate, but rather because of the inconsiderateness and carelessness at the point, additionally, the other party can be sued. Tort enables individuals to consider other individuals responsible for the wounds endured by them. The term tort is French equivalent of the English word called wrong and the Roman word called delict. The word tort is derived from the Latin term called tortum, which means twisted or crooked or the wrong, and is in contrast to the word rectum, which means straight. Now everyone is expected to behave in a straightforward manner, and when one deviates from the straight path into crooked ways, he has committed tort. That's what it means. Hence, tort is a conduct which is twisted or crooked and not straight. As a technical English term, tort has acquired a special meaning as a species of civil injury or wrong. So let us now discuss about the status of law of torts in India. In India, the term tort has been in presence since the pre-independence period. The Sanskrit word jimha, which applies slanted, was utilized as a past part of old Hindu law message in the sense of tortures of fraudulent conduct. Under the Hindu law and Muslim law, tort had much a narrower conception than the tort of the English law. The punishment of crimes in such systems occupied more prominent place than other compensation for wrongs. Now, the law of torts in India is mainly the English law of torts, which itself is based on the principle of common law of England. This was made suitable to the Indian conditions, appeasing to the principle of justice, equity and good conscience, and as amended by the acts of the legislature. Its origin is linked with the establishment of British courts in India. The expression of justice, equity and good conscience was interpreted by the Privy Council to mean the rule of English law if found applicable to Indian society and circumstances. Now, the Indian courts, before applying any rule of English law, can see whether it is suited to the Indian society and circumstances or not. The applications of the Indian law in India has therefore been a selective application. On this, the Privy Council has observed that the ability of the common law to adapt itself to the differing circumstances of the country where it has taken roots is not a weakness but one of its strength. Further, in applying the English law on a particular point, the Indian courts are not restricted to the common law only. If the new rules of English statute law replacing or modifying the common law are more in consonance with justice, equity and good conscience, it is open to the courts in India to reject the outmoded rules of common law and to apply new rules. And all these provisions are applied to the law of torts also. Now in the next video, I'll tell you about the types of torts which can be committed and the what can be the damages or the compensation which the wrongdoer has to pay. So this is it for today. Thank you. Have a nice day.